Broken Wolf, Chapter 7. Bakko Katsuki, ex-wolf listener, written by Big Bad Wolf as the fangirl, on what by a link in the description below. You wake up, slowly, your eyes opening, slowly as the sound of birds and shuffling from the hallway. Your eyes widen as your face went hot, when you saw that you were just an inch away from Bakko's chest. Looking up, you saw that he was asleep, his head tilted down, and his face peaceful. His soft and even breath fainting on your forehead. Your arms were wrapped between his chest and yours. His arms holding you close, with his legs over yours and pinning them down. Sliding down to try to get out of his arms, almost have them tighten and lower to your waist. His head lowering until his forehead touches your own. Your face was on fire, but how close you were to him. Memories of the night before suddenly flowed into your mind, after about a minute. The blonde's hold loosened and you tried to get out of his grip once again, only for him to tighten his hold. You waited again for his grip to loosen, wanting to get out of this embrace so that your face could finally cool off, your heart pounding a little and your stomach flipping, but you didn't know why. Bakko's grip never loosened, but you felt his body tense, his breath hitch from above you. Hearing that, you knew he was awake, freezing where you were and waited for him to yell at you for being close or waking him up. You look up hesitantly at Bakko, your eye-colored eyes meeting his crimson-red ones, your heart fluttering as you looked into them. His eyes were open in shock, his body tense, and a slight pink tint on his cheeks, his mouth open to say something. Beep, beep, beep. Loud beeping made you jump, your quirk activated and shifted into a wolf. Instinctively jumping out of Bakko's arms, falling off the bed, isn't he broke Chris and bringing the blanket with you? In the process, bring the blanket with you. You landed on his side, whining slightly when his chin hit the floor and made you bite your tongue. The blanket landing on you to hit your entire body, but the tip of your tail. The beak pinks up when a thump came from over your head. Your body tense when you heard it, that your feet hit the floor next to you. Your ears spin back a little as you sat up, your vision covered and smell messed up. You had turned to find the blonde. The blanket was lifted off your head, a soft chuckle coming from in front of you. Your eyes instantly met his as he smiled at you, amusement gleaming in his eyes. "You've never heard an alarm clock, have you?" he asked, his smile fading into a concerned look. "Did you get hurt?" You shook your head, any pain from the fall now gone, even though the tip of your tongue was still a little sore. A knock at the door made your head snap to it, your body tensing as Bakko cleared at it. He stood up and stalked towards the door, you taking it as a cue and dove under his bed, hunkering in the back and watched as he opened the door and a rough yank. "What the hell do you want them here?" he growled, your ears perking a little. You still stayed under the bed in case anyone else was in the hall. "You said you would explain the dog." He explained, Bakko grumbling as he stood in the doorway. "Come on, man. You know you gotta tell me what's up with her. Where did you get her? How did Asawa let you keep her?" Bakko stood in silence, his arms crossed as he stared into the redhead's eyes. His body tense and looked like he was ready for a fight. With a sigh, he paused relaxed, his hand holding the door as Yoshima smiled, showing all of his teeth. "Give me a second," Bakko grumbled, closing the door before Kishima could say anything. He watched as he walked back to the bed, crouching on the floor in front of it. I looked at you, his expression full of annoyance. He glared at the door for a second before looking at you, his crimson eyes softening, but his jaws were still set. "Is it okay if I tell Shira about this?" Bakko asked. watching you as you thought about for a moment, crawling a little so that he could see you clearly. It would be nice to have another person to know about you, just to have someone to run to if Bako wasn't around. With a hesitating nod, Bako stood up, your head resting on the floor as you waited, watching the annoyed one as he opened the door. It looked like Hiroshima straight in the eyes, his body tense, and saying he was willing to fight him.
You promise not to tell anyone of those damn nerds downstairs?
Bako test, wanting to make sure that he stayed true to his word.
I promise. It won't be very manly if I break a promise. So you can be assured I'll stay true to my word.
Kishima smiled, and you could hear the excitement in his voice. Bako checked the hallway before grabbing Kishima by his shirt and yanking him into the room, closing the door behind him. He didn't let go, instead tightening his grip and brought his other hand up, a threatening look on his face.
If you hurt or scare her, I'll blow it to hell.
Bako growled, explosions coming out of his hand, and brought it up to Kirishima's face.
She's been through enough, so I don't need your damn ass to make her upset, you understand?
Yeah, I do, just chill, man. Kirishima raised his hands, backing away when Bako let go of his shirts.
So, where's Fayan? Sit on the floor in front of the bed, and if she wants, she will come out.
Bako said, creeping close from the day and going to his room.
Leave her alone if she goes under the bed. It won't freak her out. I'll explain when I come out.
Kishima nodded and sat on the floor, smiling wildly as he looked under the bed to find you. His sharp teeth gleaming. Flashes from the fight that you have been forced through made you back up a little. A soft whimper coming from you. Bako watched, his hands on the doorknob, not really wanting to leave you alone with Kishima.
Hey, Wayan!
Kishima waved, his smile softening, so that it wasn't scary to you.
Remember me? I came in here yesterday.
You sat under the bed, looking at him intimately, starting to rethink your decision to allow him in. After about a minute, you hesitantly crawled out from under the bed, Bako finally heading in the bathroom, leaving the door slightly cracked open so he could hear what was going on. Kishima watched you, clearly trying to keep himself contained, not to pull you out from under the bed and start petting you. You now stood in front of him, your head lower as you walked slowly to him, watching for another hostile. Now you were in front of him, his hands slowly reaching out for you, making you intensely flinch, taking a step back, a small whine coming through your throat. As if you look concerned even, fell onto his face and he glanced at the bathroom, getting the wrong idea of what was going on. Taking two steps closer, now even closer to Kishima than before, getting his attention back to you. His hand reached for you and you lifted your head away, only to have his hand curve around and scratching behind your ear. It felt so good. Your tail waggled and you sat down, letting me give you an amazing friction. He leaned towards you to reach the back of your neck, hitting a spot between your shoulders that got you to lay down. Your head was in his lap, facing the bathroom behind him. You fastened on his legs and enjoyed the attention he was giving you. Bako came back into the main room, wearing a black shirt and pants. Your head raised slightly as your tail thumped on the floor. His eyes looked down at you, with some kind of emotion flashing through his face, but it was gone before you could tell what it was. Kishima looked back at Bako as he walked up to the two of you, and sat next to the redhead.
So, how long have you had her?
He asked, your ear twitching a little as you stood up only to lay back down on both boys' laps. Bako's face tinted pink as he looked down at you, your head resting on his leg, as the rest of your body, except for your pants, lay in Kishima. He has suddenly begun to stretch your ears, your eyes closing in pure bliss as Kishima found a way to scratch your stomach that made your legs twitch slightly.
Yesterday,
Bako said simply, looking only at you, his gaze softened. But face hard to show weakness to the boy next to him.
Where did you get her?
Grishima pressed, his hands going to you. To you, back and stroking through her fur.
I saved her from a bastard that used her for dog fights.
Again, simple, and saying it in the way that made it sound like it didn't matter.
What? She's a rescue?
This question made Bakugo annoyed, glaring at the boy before looking at you.
You sure you want to tell him? He mumbled, Kushima, unable to hear, but you did.
He instantly nodded and got up from the lap, sitting in front of them, looking at the floor, eyes flat and ready to reject from the redhead.
You can say she's a rescue.
Bakugo began, then explained the entire thing to Kushima. The boy staying silent and listening, his face neutral.
Now she's here. Has to stay here until Mr. Sawa finds her family or something.
There was a moment of silence. Making a shift, he paused a little as he waited for Kishima's reaction. He broke into a grin. Suddenly, a light chuckle came from him as he looked at his friends. Seeing the anger rise in Bakugo and the unbelief in Kishima's face, he made a small bark to get their attention. He shifted, Kishima's smile fading as his eyes widened, watching you turn into a human, sitting in front of them.
Hi,
you say timidly, quiet voice, smiling awkwardly, and did a small wave.
That was the fanfiction. Have you enjoyed? Sorry for bad reading as I did in the last video. I have a bit of a headache. I don't know why, but I have. But I hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you guys next video. Bye!